So it's no big surprise that once somebody has already committed one crime, that they have, you know, that they can commit it again, especially when they don't ever get punished for it. In fact, they get exonerated for it, and they're being treated like as if they were the victim, right? They murder innocent man. They acted like Mackenzie Mattingly. He says that, or no, Timothy Barnes. Timothy Barnes, who had killed Adrian Reynolds, was saying that he got lynched because he was white, right? I'm white, and that's why I had got these bad cases. And that's ridiculous. That's just bullshit. Somebody that was with Timothy Barnes was a man by the name of Cordor. So Cordor was fired by Chief Robert White, who is now in Denver, Colorado. He said, fuck Louisville. I'm going to Denver, Colorado. And Matthew Cordor, he had came across Reynolds, right? He was they said he died of unrelated injuries after a struggle with the corrections officers. Like, no, he died of related injuries to that struggle. He died because his head was smashed into the concrete, and Matthew Cordor was there. So he had come across Adrian Reynolds, who fit the description of manslaughter after a violent domestic dispute that evening. There are no witnesses to the encounter, so it was just one person's claim, right? It's just one witness. It's not discounting it. We should take all claims or complaints seriously. There are no witnesses to the encounter, and when other officers arrived, they found Reynolds soaked in blood from a fight, according to an internal affairs investigation. They found that Matthew Cordor had struck Adrian Reynolds on the head with a flashlight and punched him and broke his nose. Doug Hamilton, who is Louisville police chief, and Ron Ricciucci, who is the city's public safety officer, ruled that Matthew Cordor's actions were justified. So, you know what the fuck? He's fucking kicking his fucking ass and beat him up, and then he gets fucking beat up more, and then he's fucking dead. So Matthew Cordor is the one that started this fucking violent rampage that eventually sends Adrian Reynolds to his grave. And they, you know, the city's public safety director says that his fucking actions were justified. Matthew Cordor is also accused in a civil case of assault and battery, excessive force. In that case, he acknowledged that punching a man in January 98 at the Gardens while working security at a tough man contest. He was trying to escort a drunk and combative spectator from the building, and then the jury ruled in his favor. So he keeps on dodging all these fucking things, but he was part of the murder of Adrian Reynolds. And, you know, is it a big surprise that he keeps on getting in trouble? Like, he got away with, you know, beating the shit out of Adrian Reynolds, who eventually dies. And is it any surprise that somebody who gets away with their crimes will continue committing them? So, correction officers arrested after inmates said they used excessive force. This is April 21st, 2005. Three Louisville Metro Corrections officers found themselves on the wrong side of the law. They were arrested April 20th and suspended without pay after an inmate accused them of using excessive force while he was in handcuffs. Wave 3's Jeff Tang investigates. The three officers, Sergeant Robert Arnold, Officers Joshua Spinton, 30, and Scott DeJarnett, 28, are accused of using excessive force to subdue a jail inmate on January 16th of this year. Louisville Metro Corrections Department spokeswoman Pam Windsor says that they will remain on suspension until the charges are resolved. So Arnold Spinton and Dave Jarnett are charged with assault and official misconduct, both misdemeanors, right? They're allowed to beat whoever the fuck they want to inside the fucking inmates. The arrest warrants state that three white officers hurled racial slurs at inmate Adrian Garner, who's black, before punching and kicking him 4 or 5 minutes. So that's what the fuck they do in the jail. They just beat up fucking people just because they fucking want to. How dare you? It doesn't matter if you committed a crime or not. It's just about respect. You know, I'm the fucking boss. You'll just bow down to every command and everything I tell you what to do. And I'm going to get something to drink real fast. Sorry, I come down with the flu, so my throat's a little parched. I've been having to sleep with a cough drop in my mouth. So, Garner sustained injuries to his wrist, face, and shoulder. Adrian Garner's sister, Kianda Garner, saw her brother a few weeks after the alleged attack occurred. She says, immediately when he came through the door, my heart dropped to see all the scars and bruises on him. Kianda took pictures of her brother's injuries, and he filed a complaint with the police. In that complaint, Garner says the three officers handcuffed him and pushed him to the ground before repeatedly punching and kicking him. The report says the beating lasted for about 5 minutes. The officers yelled racial slurs while they was attacking him. Metro Corrections Chief Tom Campbell says they're investigating Garner's allegations. We take that very seriously, but right now we're waiting to take any action depending on what happens in the judicial process. The officers will remain suspended without pay until the charges are resolved. So they get a little vacation, right? A little paid vacation. The Fraternal Order of Police is defending the officers. The officers did what they were trained to do, right? And they're trained to issue, this is according to the Fraternal Order of Police, Tony Harris. And what they're trained to do is just beat the shit out of black people for about 5 minutes, sit there and say all the racial slurs that they want to, and just beat the shit out of them, beat them up, don't restrain them, don't hold them, but actually physically just punch, 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 assault, 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 first degree, second degree, third degree, fourth degree assaults. It doesn't fucking matter. According to the Fraternal Order of Police, Tony Harris, he says that's what they're supposed to do, right? You're supposed to beat up black people. You're supposed to issue racial insults. I mean, that's bullshit. This is what the fucking Louisville police are doing. Especially when you got, you know, spokespeople like this. FPO points to say, well, you know, he's had other bad past. You know, he's a repeat offender. These police officers are a repeat offender. Derek Leachman's a repeat offender. Corridor is a repeat offender. And these are the ones that we know about. You know, this shit's happening all the time. And, of course, I mean, it happened to me. I know that it happens all the time. It only happened to me. I was in jail for just a few, you know, 5 hours. And you know, for walking down the street, I got jumped in by the LMPD, by plainclothes LMPD, who tried to run me over. They say, get the fuck out of the road. I said, fuck you. And then they beat the shit out of me for that. So he's a repeat offender and knows the system, and he knows how to manipulate the system. Garner's sister, right? That's the county attorney. They know how to manipulate this system. All these boys know how to manipulate the system. They get lawyered up immediately, right? So they got liability insurance. They got legal protection. Not only can they kill people, but they got all the resources to cover their asses up. Gardner's sister's Kianda admits her brother had some problems with the law, but doesn't say that gives the police or corrections officer right to abuse him. His arrest records go back 15 years. It doesn't matter. He shouldn't be beat up. He might be locked up again, but it doesn't give him the right to beat him up and keep abusing him. She sees similarities between what happened to her brother and what happened to another prisoner in 1998. Adrian Reynolds died after correction officer Timothy Barnes subdued him by standing on his head, right? They said they subdued him by man, the way the fucking media, they fuck up this shit. He didn't just stand on his head and it murdered him. That doesn't murder somebody standing on someone's head. He stomped on his head. Stomp, stomp, stomp until his head was fucking crushed. And then he's dead, right? They crushed his head. In Garner's complaint, he says Officer Joshua Stinton threatened to use his boots if he didn't cooperate. So Joshua Stinton is trying to pull Timothy Barnes, right? I'm gonna fucking stomp your fucking head with my boots, right? And of course, you know, at the time, I bet everybody knew what happened with Timothy or with Adrian Reynolds. And so I'm gonna use these boots. You see these boots? Yeah, you're gonna try to fucking murder motherfuckers. That's what kind of, you know, you guys are psychos. And it's time for these things to stop. The officers need to be retrained. Something needs to happen down there. Gardner is currently being held at a prison in Fayette County, and all three corrections officers remain free on their own recognizance. Their first court appearance is set for April 25th. So that's essentially what I've written about all of them. I'm going to make a list of like which one of these had too many shots, why the cops are like shooting like 20 times at somebody. You had Rodney Abernathy in Chickasaw Park in 98 who got shot over two dozen times. Why are you shooting a motherfucker over two dozen times? Like, he's dead by now. You're just having fun, right? And then they're shooting him in the back. Michael Newby was shot in the back. So that is not, you know, if I shot somebody in the back, I would get, you know, rightfully so, charged with a crime. But when they shoot somebody in the back, they, you know, it's like, oh, who gives a shit? But that means something. If you're being shot in the back, that means a person isn't coming towards you. That means they're walking away from you, and you're shooting somebody walking away from you. So, I mean, A, it's cowardly. It's a bitch fucking move shooting somebody in the back. But it also says that you wasn't under any threat. You didn't have to kill him. It wasn't like your life or his life. You just wanted to end his life because you're an asshole. You're like, oh my God, what's going on? I need to kill this person, right? You're a fucking prick. Several of the cases were in plain clothes where they had killed innocent people. This is the Louisville police. So, and then a lot, most of these fucking things had no grand jury indictment. It's either not presented to the grand jury or the prosecutor sways the grand jury where they don't issue any indictment whatsoever. They was able to drop my felony charge, but they kept the misdemeanors. So they try to put assault a police officer on me. And the grand jury had dropped it down. It's the case is not a felony case. It's not a case that I need to spend 5 years in prison for. I don't go around looking to fight police. I don't look go around looking to fight anybody. I'm a very peaceful man. But people, they were looking to fight me, and they got what they wanted, right? They tried to run me over. They're cussing me out. They get in the middle of the road, a busy intersection, and they're just doing as the fuck as they please. It's absolute anarchy around here. People, they are doing whatever they want to do. There is no law and order. It's their order. It's their law. And their law is different than the Bill of Rights. It's different than the Constitution law. They have their own regulations, their own rules. And that's really fucking shitty, because that means they listen to nobody. So I'm just going to. I got another 5 minutes. I just typed in Louisville police and Google searched, and so I'm just kind of searching for some stories here. They're saying that police are beginning to track problematic officers. So problematic officers, those who have bad records, they're trying to track them. The police chase ends with a suspect in the hospital. Louisville man stole motorized grocery cart from Kroger. Police arrest Louisville man who allegedly robbed up to 25 gas stations. So, let's see. Let's Louisville police brutality. So, yeah, I'm not coming up with nothing. Louisville police innocence. Innocence. Let's actually check the Innocence Project. I know it's dead air, whatever. So, if you don't want to watch me Google shit, the Innocence Project. So, Louisville Police Innocence. Exoneree Carrie Porter sues Louisville, Kentucky for wrongful conviction. Kentucky detective demoted. Innocent bystanders were in the crosshairs of paint gun. Four people shot. Innocent driver injured. Louisville man proclaims innocence in a prison interview. LMPD detectives looks into inmates' innocence claims. So, they've already sent several, they've murdered several innocent people. They're throwing many innocent people into prison that we know about. So to think that they can do this again is not a surprise at all. Let's see, this is December 20th, 2012. Carrie Porter suing Louisville for wrongful conviction. 27-page complaint says the city and Metro Police condone the misconduct, failing to track and identify officers repeatedly accused of the same kinds of serious misconduct. So actually, by the police that have problematic records, that's a good thing. The prosecutor is finally doing, but that's something the defense should have done. That's something that they should have just been doing on their own. So actually, good work by the prosecutor. That prosecutors want good fucking stellar people in the communities to be able to testify that what they saw. If they have all these marks against them, that goes against their credibility. They're not good fucking people. You're not, Derek Leachman's pulling a pistol out on fucking women and being like, "Back the fuck up, bitches. I'm a fucking man with a gun and a badge. I've already killed somebody. I lie on my fucking under oath. I perjure for over six times. I don't give a shit. And what the fuck are you gonna do?" That's Derek Leachman of the LMPD. And so when you have Derek Leachman saying that you've done something wrong, well, Derek Leachman, you've been, doing things wrong over and over and over again, and you're still free out in the streets. So not only is your credibility wrong, you should be behind bars. And you definitely shouldn't be testifying and saying that somebody else is doing wrong, because you have no compass. You have no moral compass or ethical compass about what is right and what is wrong. So, how much should an exoneree be compensated? Can you put price of the actions for somebody for 14 years? There's $12 million were paid out to Edwin Chandler and William Gregory. Payment of multi-million-dollar settlements and wrongful conviction cases can be an indication of systematic flaws in the legal system. Kentucky currently does not have a state compensation law for wrongful convictions. It seems that one is needed now. So they are getting a shit ton of fucking money for these wrongful convictions, and that's their fucking the paper is saying we need it. We can't have people getting all this money for. No, you need to stop throwing innocent people in fucking prison. West Liberty, Kentucky, Janelle McDonald. Almost every person convicted of serious crime goes down the system. They didn't do it. Carrie Porter's no different. So yeah, right. If you all criminals deny that they fucking did it, Well, that's actually like I'm an honest person, so I would admit that I would do something if I had done something, and then people would be like, "Oh, you admitted to it." I remember I told this one police officer that when I was 18 years old, I had an empty cup in my hand. He's like, "Where'd you get that empty cup?" And I was like, "Oh, I was at a party," and he smelled it and had alcohol residue on it. And then he's like, "Well, since you admitted to me, I'm going to go ahead and cite you." And then the one police officer was like, "Oh, just tell me the truth, it'll be cool." And I said it was cool with him, but then I kept on being like, "Man, what up? You said it was cool. You said it's cool." And then he was like, "Shh." And just started being a fucking prick, just being a total fucking prick, right? He said it'd be cool, but he wasn't cool. He lied. And what, cops lie? Big fucking surprise. Cops are pigs? Big surprise to at least people that are on the streets and know what's going on.